Alrighty, welcome to another Vintage Cube video where we got some powerful cards here. There's a Mox Emerald, a Time Walk, a Fable of the Mirror Breaker, and a Swords to Plowshares. Honestly, these cards aren't as far apart as you might think. Fable of the Mirror Breaker is one of the best cards in Cube. Swords is the best removal in Cube. Of course, Mox and Time Walk, both quite good. Easily Time Walk, though. I think Time Walk is well ahead of the Moxen, unless you really want to play Mono Red or Mono White, but I'm of course very happy. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4 are gone. 5, 6, 7, 8. Maybe an Intrepid Adversary. Yeah, there's not much is coming back that we care about. Oh, well. I mean, if it's open, like, I'm really beholden to reading the draft and trying to figure out. It's called drafting the hard way. Bennis, I'm sure, would approve. He's also a big Cube enjoyer. But in that sense, Brain Freeze Breach is open. You know, when you get a really clear signal, what are you going to do? Certainly can't take a mana leak there when Brain Freeze is just so open. Look at this. Very, very close to a perfect start. We're Underworld Breach and LED away from just having it all. I guess when you have LED Breach, Brain Freeze, you kind of want Demonic Tutor more than Time Walk, but I'm not going to complain, I will say. Let's just say we're off to a good start this fine evening. After all, why shouldn't we take Brain Freeze? Is there a reason not to? I don't think there is. I think that we're reading the signals as best we can. Third pick, a little less excited here. There's a Dig Through Time and a Force of Negation. Those are both good cards. There's also a Utopia Sprawl for the blue-green version, but you know what? This might be controversial, but because of a certain card, of which I will mention later, I think Dig Through Time is actually where I'm at now. Normally, I would take Force Negation there, but let's just say I'm dreaming of a specific card which lets me cast Dig Through Time at the low, low cost of pitching a blue card. So we're in there. Among the best of the best Cube cards, where does Time Warp rank? I think third. After Lotus and Sol Ring. Well, Lotus, Sol Ring, Ancestral Time Walk are my top four. And it's a little bit contextual. I think all of these are just that good. Hey, Sponzi, with the 91 months, man is obsessed with Dream Halls. Yeah, I'll let my brother, Sponzi, spoil it. Dream Halls is, in fact, the card I'm currently obsessed with, and so far, BK, what are we at? Like 3 trophies in a row with just taking Dream Halls? 4 if you count the busted deck I had before you guys showed up. Here we've got Vendilion Click and Chart of Course. I'm actually not sure about them, which one I want most. I would like to wheel Time Walk because it's really a real regrowth because it's nice with Time Walk. But I don't think I'm supposed to take it over Vendilion Click. This pack's also pretty good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, I mean, it's very plausible. That regrowth wheels here. What's up with morale? Oh, for those who can't see it right now, the title of this stream is The Cubing Will Continue Until Morale Improves. This is, of course, a reference to the classic the floggings will continue until morale improves joke. Pretty easy Mystical Tutor here. Once you have Time Walk and Brain Freeze, Mystical Tutor gets significantly more worth. Not passing anything of note here. Boom, 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 boom. This is the first pack where I think I'm kind of an underdog to play any of these cards. I might take Fury because if you end up red-blue, it's a really good card against the aggro decks. There's also Fatal Push. Maybe I'll take Fatal Push because the cost of playing this is a lot less. You just need a black source. I don't think Fallen Shinobi or Suspicious Stowaway is particularly important for this kind of deck. The Iron Mountain, welcome to the divination. Hey, what's up, El Gran Boa? How you doing? Do we storm good? I'm hoping so. This is a good start to storm. I will say that. Another sleeper card, which I'm pretty high on. Helm of Awakening. Let's just say it's even. Spells cost one less to cast. Affects both players. One player might be casting more spells than the other player, in which case Helm of Awakening is slightly better for them, but we'll see. Audiz with the 14 months, welcome, welcome. Hope you're having a good one. And, oh, that's a late fast bond. This is more appropriate to where fast bond is probably supposed to be. It's not a card most decks are going to be able to take the best use of. I like Brazy B and all that, but I'm going to take fast bond here because if you get some draw sevens, fast bond's great. Wow. Oracle and... I kind of don't understand what happened with this pack. Because Vindicate, Oracle, Voidwalker, and Grist were four of the cards I thought would be taken. People took some cards out of this. I think I'm just going to take Oracle here. Oracle does some good things for this sort of deck. Ooh, I could be very much in blue-green storm. In which case... Hold on, let me just... let me just look here. Do I want this Augur of Autumn? I mean, Bayou is obviously great if I get a tutor. Augur is nice with Fast Bond. I'm going to take Bayou, though. I think the fact that I'm going to want tutors, well, now I kind of wish I took Augur, but I'm still going to take the Overgrown Tomb. I just don't think making myself the Monarch with Court of Bounty is a very good idea. So let's just do that. Had I known Overgrown Tomb was wheeling, I would have taken Augur probably because it is good with fast bond, but I don't like it a double green card all that much in this kind of deck. I guess this is actually technically there. Dig is like over here. Well, our dig through times are going to cost two, so. Yeah, I like this start. We've got a Mystical Tutor, Time Walk, Brain Freeze. Fast bond, we're really looking for draw sevens with this fast bond and Mystical Tutor. Ah, interesting. All right, well, the card I wanted to wheel didn't wheel, and I don't even remember which one that is at this point, but I guess I'll take Lingering. No, I'll just take Craterhoof to not send green signals, though it doesn't matter too much. Luteral Core, Regrowth, that's what it was, yeah. I was hoping Regrowth would wheel. But if no one was drafting Mono Green, that it would make sense. Actually, I think Burge is slightly more likely to be played than Eureka, but I don't really play either of them. All right. Well, great pack one. What do we get pack two? Honestly, Raghavan is a fantastic card. I think in this deck, I've got to take... Whoa, there it is. There it is. There's the Breach. I missed it. I was taking looking at Vamp first, but no. We're with a Brain Freeze out, we take the Breach. Also, Breach with Time Walk is a fantastic combo. I don't think there's anything that really could tempt me away from Breach, not even the monkey itself. All right, let's just take Underworld Breach. If we're really lucky, we'll wheel Vampiric Tutor. And then there's also a Chain of Vapor, which I got my own. Tonight's my night. Getting past Ancestral Recall. Can't complain about that. Even I can't complain about that. It would be nice if this Ketria Triome wheeled. I suppose we could ask for that. All right, well... I think the way this happens, you remember we opened Mox Pearl or Mox Emerald and Time Walk, took the Time Walk past the Emerald. If the person passing to us was like non-blue and opened a Mox, just take the Mox. You don't need to like contort your deck to play Ancestral. Like imagine the person we're passing to was blue, was mono white. If they opened Mox Pearl and Ancestral, it's not close. You take the Ancestral. Also not close, I'm going to take Time Twister. Wouldn't mind wheeling Thassa's Oracle if such a thing came to pass, but really not too worried about this. I mean, Time Twister plus Fast Bond, really good combo. Could use some lands. These Bayou and Overgrown Tomb aren't doing a whole lot for me at the moment. But this is looking nice. We're doing pretty well for ourselves. Oh, and Mana Vault here. Mind's Desire almost a lock to table because no one ever plays that card. Mana Vault is absurdly good here with your Time Twisters and whatnot. Do you need High Tide? I would take High Tide in most packs. I don't think it's a big deal whether this deck has High Tide. I mean, obviously, Lion's Eye Diamond is the card we want the most. Well, Black Lotus is the card we want the most, but Lion's Eye Diamond we would certainly take very close to that. I would take, at this point, a Lion's Eye Diamond over a Mox. It's just the combo with Brain Freeze, Underworld Breach is so good. This deck could be a unicorn? I mean, yes, having Ancestral Time Walk is obviously just crazy good, but I found Storm to be really good in this iteration of the cube, so we'll see. We'll see what ends up happening as we draft here. And pretty happy with everything so far. The biggest bottleneck for Storm is tends to be making mana, and with Fast Bond, Mana Vault, Helm of Awakening, we're pretty good at that. Time Walk also works pretty nicely. Ah, Squirrel Loot. Just in time. Just in time indeed. And I think given the what's going on at this table, I feel like I'm going to get past a good amount of stuff. This pack is not really that juicy. I mean, I'll take Memory Jar. I don't really like Memory Jar all that much, but there are definitely reasons to play. It's just so expensive is the main problem. And I don't think Oath of Druids is particularly good. So I think we'll do this thing. Akalios Sparrow, welcome back. Hey, what's up, Andrew? Hope your arena thing went all right. I don't know. I assume you played in that. If you are a grinder, if you're interested in playing high level Magic, certainly playing the arena qualifiers is a good idea. What do we got here? So we've got Uro, which I do kind of like, with just being able to play a bunch of lands and draw sevens. There's Heartbeat, but we don't have any untap effects at the moment, so Heartbeat isn't that great. I mean, Time Walk kind of counts. When you go Heartbeat into Time Walk and then untap, you have 8 mana or whatever. There's also Springbloom Druid, which is nice because I can go get my red source and blue sources. I'm kind of thinking of this Springbloom here. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So someone needs to take Tezzeret, Agent of Bolas, Goryeo's Vengeance, 2 of those 3 for me to wheel something like a Heartbeat. That seems doable. I'm not really stoked about Heartbeat in this deck. Oh, there it is, the busted card. Dream Halls is crazily good in this kind of deck, and I will do my best to show you how that works out. I mean, turn 1, Mana Vault, turn 2, Dream Halls, pitch a blue card, cast Dig, pitch a blue card, cast Time Twister, you know, so on and so forth. Some good stuff. How do you get this lucky? Well, honestly, getting a Dream Halls 8th pick isn't that lucky. No one takes the card. I'm ruining it for me and BK in the future. I apologize, BK. But all we've been doing is drafting Dream Halls decks. So there's most tables only have one person who wants this card. Actually, that's not true. Most tables have 0 people who want this card. I just happen to be that person almost every time I'm at a table. Someone asked, any thoughts on the Apple Series Silo? Very big fan. I'm going to take Turnabout here. This is a great, great pickup. I was a fan of Wool, or the series it was based on. They changed their name to Silo, which I think makes a lot of sense. It's a much better name overall. And I think that, I read it a long time ago. I actually barely remember what was happening in it. And Silo has been good. I've liked it. I can see that, Squirrel. All right, well, Chain of Vapor Wield. I don't think I'm that big into Rexage. There's also Arcane Proxy to cast like a Time Walk or something. My problem with Arcane Proxy is it's not a blue card. Once you have Dream Halls, you really care about what color your cards are. And I find actually having access to a Chain of Vapor is kind of decent. I just don't think that is too much. Okay. I'm not really a Lotus Bloom enjoyer. Mishra's Bauble is interesting. It's kind of nice with shuffle effects. And it's good with Dig Through Time. But Lotus Bloom's also nice with Time Walk. All right, you know what? Look, this is me throwing BK a bone here. I'm going to try Lotus Bloom and see how that works. All right, I'll take Thassa's Oracle. Told you Mind's Eye would wheel. Very good with Dream Halls. Okay, I'll take the Oath even though I'm not going to play it. And then Heartbeat didn't need wheel. So this is all coming up, Millhouse. All right. This is some pretty good stuff. What are we missing? I mean, a Lion's Eye Diamond would be pretty nice. I feel like we deserve it. And here it is. So, you know, if you wanted a masterclass in getting the right cards, here we are. All right. Well, we're not even going to try to wheel it. Even I'm not that greedy. It's just too good in the deck. And maybe Aetherflux Reservoir will come back. I wouldn't mind that one. There's also a Moldrifter. All right, well, here we go. And there's a Phrantic Search. I mean, I like Snapcaster and all, but Phrantic Search is just unbelievable in this deck, so we're going to take that. Honestly, no jokes. What I am looking for is lands. I actually have enough playables now, and I would love to pick up just a couple lands would be nice. If I pick up zero non-basics, I actually think we'll still be okay because Spring Bloom and Oracle help, as well as just drawing a lot of cards with things like Ancestral and Time Twister. But I mean, something like a volcanic island or a tropical island would be very, very much appreciated, though. I will take a Remand. Remand is also fantastic. This actually is a deck that would play Paradoxical Outcome, so when that inevitably wheels, I probably will take it. It would have Z-Bowls. Would I take High Tide or Tropical Island? Oh, easy Trop, because I think I'd also wheel High Tide. All right, oh, Miscalc here. Miscalc is the two mana counters are really good in these Storm decks because it lets you kind of interact and then pretty easily win from there. So Thassa's Oracle. I actually might play it over Lotus Bloom here. I think you don't have to main deck Thassa's Oracle, but if your deck's good enough, it's reasonable to do so because otherwise, if you have only Brain Freeze as a win condition, it's basically two main risks. The first one is that they have an Emrakul or Ulamog in their deck, in which case you can't win. Like this deck, well, this deck could win technically by going Vendilion Click and time walking a bunch of times with a Breach. There is that. That's actually a pretty decent backup. You go off, you Brain Freeze them, it doesn't work. You Brain Freeze almost your whole deck down to like two cards or one card or whatever, and then you go Vendilion Click and then cast three time walks. Yeah. You can Ancestral them in response, but honestly, that doesn't really work with the Eldrazi. Like, it's pretty hard to do that. What you'd actually, that's not true. So let's say they have an Eldrazi. What we do is, assuming we get to play our whole deck, right? We went off with Brain Freeze, Breach, and LED. I can Brain Freeze them. The Eldrazi triggers. In response, I remand the Brain Freeze, the original one, and then cast it again to deck them and then Ancestral them. It takes a lot of resources, but it's possible. All right, well, I love Minsk and Boo. It's a really, really good card. But I'm gonna take Breeding Pool. I think this deck is already just completely locked on. Oh my God, there's a time spiral. This deck just has every single thing it needs. It does not need a Minsk and Boo. This isn't someone, someone asked Breeding Pool is easy because Minsk is insane, but this is the wrong deck. No, this is still the right deck for Minsk and Boo. It's just that it's actually that good. You just cast it and you always win. All right, well, we don't need I've talked myself out of Thassa's Oracle because of the Brain Freeze, Remand, Ancestral combination. So I think that there's that. The green looks cuttable. It's possible. Fast Bond is absurdly good in this deck too, with I have a Time Spiral, a Time Twister, and a Mystical Tutor, so I have a lot of draw sevens. Fastbond draw seven is very good. There's also a Jar. I guess I have three. I could also cut the Spring Bloom Dryad and then the Heartbeat if I want. Although Heartbeat's nice with three untap effects. We'll see. We'll see. We'll see where we end up. I mean, right now, I think the cards I'd put in, like Chain of Vapor and Thassa's Oracle, are not good enough to warrant cutting the green, I don't think. Well, I'll take a Taxing Probe. That'll work out nicely here. All right, I get one more pick to see another maybe dual land or something. Isn't Jar cuttable? Yeah, Jar's very cuttable. Also, it's colorless, which does not work with Dream Halls, so I do kind of want to keep fairly close to all like blue cards if I can. I kind of wish I had a red card to cast Underworld Breach with off of Dream Halls, but I don't really want to put a Burgee in my deck. If they have an Eldrazi, I'll bring in the Oracle because while the Ancestral Remand play I think can win the game, it is laborious. Not a red and six deck though. That would be a red and green card for Breach. Omnath is cute, can pitch to anything. I think Spire Bluff Canal is just going to be where I want to be. Seems pretty hard to pass up a dual land there. And this is currently the amount of cards I want to play. Channel and Aetherflux Reservoir both wheeled, so did Nissa. I don't think this is an Aetherflux Reservoir deck. I don't really need to do that. I already have enough win conditions. This is mainly a win condition. Though it's nice with Bolas's Citadel, gives you life to fuel things. I don't think Channel does much for me. It's too hard to cast. I guess I'm gonna take Nissa, because maybe I'd side it in. Yeah, I don't know. I don't think I'm playing any of those cards. I mean, this is 17 land. This is, oh. All right, Expressive Iteration is interesting. I'm not going to play the other cards. Iteration being a red card for Breach is for when it comes to Dream Halls is kind of nice, actually. Oh, PO did wheel. All right, well, let's take a look here. Oh, BK just 3-0'd. Here, let's see here. Just so we can see another 3-0 deck. This is Breach, Dream Halls, Echo of Eons, Dig, Time Spiral, a bunch of like Lion's Eye Diamond, Brain Freeze, you know, all that thing. Mono Blue splashing a tiny bit of red. Very nice. Very nice. That's a classic. I guess I'll take Primal Command as a sideboard card. Hey, thanks, Jivan. Let me take a look here. I think it is possible. No, I can't really get away from Fast Bond. I was trying to wonder if I made it like a blue-red deck with just Iteration, Spire Bluff Canal. I don't think so. Let's see. Dreamhold's Upheaval is like kind of a combo. I don't think I'm going to play Riftwing anyway, so... Sorry, Riftwing. This isn't the deck for you. Still love you. Oh, I actually don't hate a Brain Geyser here. All right. Let me see. So the main problem with cutting green entirely is then I'm a lot more reliant on drawing Dream Halls than if I didn't do that. But I might actually still want to do it. Because I also get a Chain of Vapor back as like a little bit of disruption and maybe a Thassa's Oracle. All right, let's see what it looks like without, I mean, here's my creatures. So this is the red-blue version and I would play Spire Bluff Canal and like three mountains and like the rest, and 13 islands or something like that. Because I'd have four red sources plus the LED. Though LED casting Breach is pretty hard to do. And then if I played green, I would get to play Breeding Pool and I'd play a couple forests and I'd play a Fast Bond. I mean, there's also just, this is why I wish I had a Lotus Petal. I mean, I guess you always kind of wish that. What would I cut though? I mean, I guess I don't really need Chain of Vapor and Thassa's Oracle is the thing. Oh, I already don't even have the Oracle in. Yeah, Time Walk does make it a little less likely. You know what? I think I'm going to start with the red version. Oracle, I'm not that sad about missing out on, especially since it's the only creature they can kill in the deck. Okay. I could also cut Chain of Vapor for Lotus Bloom, but I think having a Chain of Vapor is not the worst. I also have Mind's Eye. When you go like Chain on Lion's Eye Diamond, Sack of Land, Chain on Mana Vault, replay them, cast a Desire, like Chain of Vapor plus Mind's Desire, like plus those two is like a Desire for like six or whatever. Paradoxical Outcome is like borderline here, but it can do some things. Basically, I don't think Burgee is there very good. Birdie is just not, I think, a very good card. There's also Memory Jar. I hate Memory Jar so much, though. All right. Okay. Sorted by color. Nice. All right. I don't know. I don't actually know the right way to build this. I'm going to go three mountains and 13 islands. Something like that. That should probably be enough. It's not like I have High Tide. So I don't think it's that big of a deal. Time Walk getting me the extra red land drop is pretty nice. Okay, well, this deck I think is very good. I wonder if it's better to play Thassa's Oracle over Chain of Vapor. Having the one chain to tutor for, like, if they play a Narset, like, I saw BK playing today, and his opponent played a Narset, and, like, every card in his deck drew a card, so it was pretty bad. There's also cutting Paradoxical Outcome. It's not crazy to want to cut. So it's pick one, pack three. You have Ancestral Recall and Opposition as your first two cards. Would you take Prismatic Vista or Demonic Tutor? I'd take Demonic Tutor. But I also wouldn't second pick Opposition, so it's kind of hard for me to know. I can't really construct a pack where I would do that. Unless you really want to play with it. Totally fine, too. Yeah, High Tide would have been really good in this deck, and that would have made it really easy to want to cut the green. Though at this point, basically, is it worth playing Breeding Pool and two forests to play a Fast Bond? I don't really think so. I think we're adding a little bit too much there, though. I'm not sure about this Paradoxical Outcome. It is definitely the weakest card here. I could Lotus Bloom over that, but having blue cards for Dream Halls is pretty nice. All right. This hand is probably just miscalc whatever you play on turn two, and then cast Time Twister on turn three. Not like the most exciting thing in the world, but it's definitely fine. Would have very heavily prioritized picking up more lands. Just, we saw a Ketria Triumph, but it wasn't anything. Ooh, okay. This is actually the own. Oh my god, Eternal Rogabon. All right. Well, at least most of my cards don't do anything for them, but there are some cards if they exile would be really annoying. This is a beating, though, because they're just going to have access to a ton of mana here. I think that the only deck that I really don't want to play against with these kinds of decks is Mono Red, typically. Even just the blue decks with counters aren't that hard to outmaneuver, but them doing this here is tough. Okay, they got a lot of land. I kind of want to just pass for another turn. I'm just going to sit here getting hit by Rogavan, which sucks, but I'm not really doing much. Against Island Go, it doesn't really seem great to just tap out here. Yeah, turn on Rogavan is very good. Okay, they're doing other stuff too. I don't mind this. Oh. They got some nice cards, not gonna lie. Hopefully they don't have a Force of Will. Wow. Force backup, or do they have Days? Felt like they were trying to play something there. Okay. Let's see. Getting hit. If they get my Brain Freeze, it's really annoying. All right, they got another land. Not so bad. There's the Brain Freeze. Yeah, they could easily have Force of Negation. This is true. I'm kind of feeling that. I'm just going to go Time Twister here and see what they do. Because if they have Force of Negation and they Force of Negation it, then I traded, Pitching Mana Drain. Wow. Okay, this matchup looks hard so far. Like, they have Mana Drain, Force of Negation, and then Minsk and Boo, which is a really fast clock. Rogamon is disgusting here because it's just a Birds of Paradise that stacks every turn you even get the to keep the mana like stacking up if you don't use it. Okay. Yeah, that's a good card too. Sure. What are they going to do with it? Add mana? To the Fable? Okay. All right. This person's deck is definitely something. I will say that. Let's go ahead and Brain Geyser for two. Okay, Mana Vault, interesting. Yeah, every single card, like the worst card we've seen so far is Chandra, Torch of Defiance. Every other card, Fable, Minskin, Boo, Rogavan, Mana Drain, Force Negation are all really high picks. Force Negation is a little less, but in this matchup, it's actually one of the best cards in the cube. They only discarded one of their two cards, which I don't love. They exiled a Glennon, Elendra Archmage? Are you kidding me? Come on. This chain of vapor actually was going to do some work, but now. All right, sure. Okay. They exiled an island. Okay, let's start with Time Walk. They're gonna Glen it. We could have tried to see if LED was in the top nine cards. I didn't think it was, we were quite at that spot yet. Oh, they're gonna Glen this? Okay. That's kind of nice, actually. I didn't think they were gonna do that. All right, I guess I'll just pass. Okay. If they have something else, we're definitely gonna lose. Obviously, we could still lose even if they don't have something else, but we'll see. All right, I go. They're probably gonna hit Time Walk here. I don't want to use Chain of Vapor here because I want to be able to cast it on my turn. They hit Frantic Search. Oh man, that would have been a good one. But at least it goes to my graveyard. Oh, they just didn't want to put it in my graveyard. Sure. All right. Let's turn about here. Yeah, of course. Snapcaster Force Negation. If I had to construct a deck to that would beat me, it would be the opponent's deck. I kind of want to play green just because I get to play a couple creatures here. Let's see. So if I did, if I took out Chain of Vapor, I could put in Fast Bond, Oracle, Spring Bloom, go down to like one mountain and a thing, four forests. Two islands. I don't know that I even want to play Heartbeat. Paradoxical Outcome can probably get cut because it's just the worst card. Oh yeah, I definitely want a Breeding Pool over an island here. Or actually probably over a forest. I think four green sources. Man, Spring Bloom's really just not that good. Even if it blocks Roggavan, I don't think I can afford that. Right, well, hopefully they don't turn one Roggavan me, I guess. Okay, this is kind of nice. Let's just go turn one Fast Bond. Okay, they didn't force a negation it. I'm just gonna wait here and then upkeep Ancestral so they can't force a negation. Obviously, they're going to have Force of Will as well. Okay, they didn't have turn on Roggavan either. Oh my god, okay. Wait, I spoke too soon. They suspended Riftwing. Okay, that I'm totally fine with, though. All right, I'm not going to burn a Time Walk here, but if I just Ancestral into all lands, then I am still going to lose, yes. Okay. Getria Triome, Chart a Course, sure. Glad they played their land first. They could have drawn into Roggavan Mountain. Okay, action. Nope. Yeah, playing against Teemer first picks is tough. They've shown us 15 so far, but. I wouldn't mind so much if they didn't have Literal Force of Negation and Glenlyn Archmage. Both those cards are extremely hard to beat for this deck. Okay, here's the Roggavan. They hit an island, so that at least helps me. Play a land and Fable of the Mirror Breaker. Yep. Okay, they have two cards left. They're about to have three because the Roggavan's going to bounce. Hopefully, it's not Force of Negation and a blue card. Because otherwise, I'm actually in pretty good shape here. All right, let's go. Mm-hmm. Ooh, there we go. There we go. Mm-hmm. Okay, drawing time spiral was all we needed, really. Land, untap. Unfortunately, we now time spiral them into force of negation, but that's okay. I'm not going to sack the LED because I don't really need to. I have a lot of mana, especially with Helm and Fast Bond. I guess not having a red source was the main thing. I do have an extra turn floating, remember. So let's go Mystical Tutor. They have Force of Negation now, I think. And next turn, what do I want to do? I mean, I could just Time Twister. It's not like crazy, but it is good. I actually should have sacked. Thinking about the red cards means I actually realized I should have sacked LED. Well, the problem with getting brain freeze or something, I don't need a ton of advice on remanding my own spells. Well, no, I'm not putting the card in my hand. I could play turnabout and remand it. The problem is if they have force and then they force the turnabout, I'm just completely dead. So I think I'm just going to get Time Twister here. My deck's pretty gassy and I'll have played a bunch of lands. I guess I don't really need to play them now. It doesn't really matter. Whatever. I can just play. I'll play one next turn. I'll have tons of mana. I'm again not sacking the LED though, which is the funny part, but. Let's just start with turnabout. Land, untap. Time Twister. Now they're gonna force the negation it. Yep, and I'm gonna remand the Time Twister. Oh, now actually I probably should have sacked LED though. Actually, let's cast Dig Through Time. I think we can exile Turnabout. I don't really want to draw a Turnabout again after the Time Twister. And then here we've got Mind's Desire. Oh, Storm Count of 5. Let's just go Frantic Search, Mind's Desire. Frantic Search, discard, Expressive Iteration, definitely. I guess I'll actually discard Brain Geyser because I'm going to go off pretty hard here. This gets exiled, or that resolves. Play this. And then Mind's Desire for 8 here. And I think we're in pretty much close to unlosable territory now. Mm-hmm. Ooh, Vendilion Click, not bad. Oh, Time Walk, okay. Yeah, so let's go. I don't need to, I'm at 14, so I guess I don't really have to worry about burn. Let's go land. Land. I still have a miscalc to cast at any point. Let's cast Time Walk. And then let's cast Time Twister. And now I'm definitely not sacking LED. And now if they have Force of Negation, I have the stuff able to counter it. I'm definitely not going to play Dream Halls here. Let's start with Gitaxian Probe here. Can't wait to see what's in their hand. Ooh. Brazen Borrower, Pest Infestation, Fiery Confluence. Yeah, they got some nice ones. Chandra, cast another Time Walk. Cast, oh, I guess I'll untap the red. Cast Oracle. My library has a remand. All right, let's go. Now we're just kind of getting through here. Because I just need to find Brain Freeze. Breach also works. Let's cast Breach. I could actually kill them with Vendilion Click, but like I don't really need to do that. My library has a Mind's Desire. No, I don't really want to do that. Let's go Frantic Search. Exiling, Breeding Pool, Island, and Gitaxian Probe. I mean, I don't care about their hand. Discard these two. Untap these three, and then... Yeah, I guess we Brain Freeze them for a million here. And they're probably... Okay, they don't have... They do not have an Eldrazi. Whew. Their deck, man. It's going to be hard. If they ever just open on Raghavan, I probably can't win. But, I mean, what are you going to do, right? The good thing is we didn't see any new counter spells that game. We still saw the Force of Negation. But, all right, let's see. Let's see what we got. What a weekend. I guess I do get to Ancestral pretty soon, though. Guess I got to keep. Okay, that's no Raghavan. I like that. Let's just pass here. I think we can pass. I don't think I need to probe first. Land. Let's just wait a little bit here. Because the other thing is if I draw Ancestral, this Mystical could end up setting me up really nicely as well. And they're not putting any pressure on me at the moment. Yeah, let's just wait. As long as we're both hitting land drops, because the other thing is if I save Probe until a Mind's Desire turn, I get a lot more value. Glen Alendra is a card I'm worried about. So maybe it was actually Mox into Glen Alendra was kind of what concerned me. Oh, they didn't play a land though. And didn't play anything. Oh. Let's just pass. And they're not doing anything else. Nice. Land. All right. I could probe. No, I'm going to wait one more turn here. Ventura land. Sure. I'm going to cast Mystical Tutor because otherwise I'm going to get Ancestral. Otherwise I'm going to discard. No, I really don't want to discard. I wish I had one more mana here. It would be really helpful. Let's go Gitaxian Probe and see. Mana Vault would be the goat draw for me. Their hand is Force of Negation. They have Force of Will too? Oh my god. And Snapcaster? Okay, but they can only cast one of... No, they can cast two of their counters. Okay. So what now? They can't do anything if I pass. They can play Snapcaster Go. That doesn't do anything. I'm just going to pass here. I'm giving up one storm count, but I think that's okay. And if they play Minskin Boo, if they drew a land and played Minskin Boo, then they'd be giving up one of their counters, which is also important. They drew a Mox. That doesn't really change anything, right? They have two counters up at best. They can hard cast Force, pitch Force Negation. They can pitch Force and then Snapcaster it. Yeah, no matter what they do, they've got two counters. Oh, a Time Walk. Interesting. How much do I care if they counter Time Walk? Mm-hmm. I don't know if I care. I don't know if I care a lot. Let's start with time walk. Yeah, they're gonna force of negation it. Okay. You gonna force a will this? Oh, okay. That I don't think was a very good play, but I'm actually really happy that it happened, because now they can't even play Minsk and Boo right now. Okay, now they can play Minsk and Boo, and I think I'm in pretty good shape. They know I have Ancestral Recall in my hand. Okay, there we go. I mean, I'm gonna take, what, 6 damage this turn? They have 2 forces, so I would prefer not to Time Spiral if I can avoid it, though obviously I might not be able to. Let's start with Ancestral. Man, all right. Well, I'm gonna have to give them their counters back, unfortunately. I can't desire for 3. That's not good enough. All right, well, Time Spiral, and then I'm gonna sack this. I just don't think I have enough mana. I'm gonna sack this for red. Let's go Helm. Didn't even draw a very good Time Spiral, but that's okay. Sure, I don't mind that too much. Yeah, I mean, this is probably enough to brain freeze them at this point, but let's let this bounce. See if this resolves. Helm. Breach. Frantic Search. Yeah, let's go Frantic Search. Wait, hold on. Let's tap an extra mana. There we go. Frantic Search. Boom, boom, boom. Discard those 2. Untap these 3. V-click them. Just to make sure, I guess. Dismember it, sure. Their hand is Chart of Course, yep, no. And Brain Freeze you. For 13 spells, got any Eldrazi? Oh, feels good, man. They have a Mock Sapphire too. They are losing with the best cube deck they're ever going to have. You love to see it. You just love to see it. I mean, I say that without malice. Their deck was busted. It was every single good card in those colors in the cube with 2 Moxes. One of them was a Mox Diamond, but still. You do, in fact, love to see it. Yeah, my R deck's really strong, too. I'm not complaining about R deck, but let's just say it feels good to beat Raghavan, Minsk, Fable, all that stuff. Oh, I have 0 complaints about how good my deck is. this is a okay hand. It's on the draw. I would love to pick up a Lion's Eye Diamond here and then just win very easily, but Mana Vault would also be really good. Turn 1 Mana Vault, turn 2 Dream Halls. But better yet, Chain of Vapor. Yeah, if I got to turn 2 Dream Halls, then I would be like, probably just pitch and Time Twister or something like that. don't mind playing against black in general. Hand disruption can be a little annoying, but this deck's pretty good against it. Oh no, they're going to him my island. Okay, they got my worst card in hand, and then a Dream Halt, which is fine, but Island and Time Twister are both pretty critical, so they're probably looking at those two cards like, what are you talking about? Oh, and they're going to grief me too? All right. Obviously, I don't love it, because getting rid of Time Twister is rough, but having Breach Brain Freeze in hand means I'm not that far away from having a potential for explosiveness. Hey, thanks for the raid, Seti. Hope you're doing well. Hope the NBA action is good. I mean, oh, they took the Breach. All right, sure. Okay, well, I do need to now draw a land, but they also, that was a 3-for-3. And they mulligan, so they're not on tons of resources. Yeah, they didn't do anything here. Spire Bluff. Just kind of Time Twister, I think. I don't know. No reason to wait and get it duressed. Nah. Okay, I'm not loving giving them a whole fresh hand if this is the hand I'm going to draw, but this hand still does some things. Also, they exiled a Vraska, Golgari Queen, which means they're a deck that's probably not doing much in the way of bustedness. Inquisition's okay here. I don't really have much to take. Yeah, like they can take Time Walk, but it's not like Time Walk is crazy good or anything. Okay. Black Green Rock. Let's just find another draw seven or an expressive iteration or something like that. Would not mind. Oh, Mystical Tutor actually kind of does the trick. So I'm going to draw step V click them because I can then Mystical for Ancestral. I could also Mystical for Time Spiral, but I'm one mana short of casting it. I'm going to do this so I can see what they're up to. Yeah, I mean, they have Inquisition, him, Grief. Look, people are good at drafting cube these days. It's not going to be easy, you know. My last opponent had a bunch of great cards. This opponent has a bunch of discard, which is pretty good. Good lord, Collective Brutality, Mind Twist, Metamorph, Crop Rotation. All right, they have a lot of discard. I guess I'll take Mind Twist. And then they're going to Collective Brutality me and then miss. I like that. Well, they might not Collective Brutality me because they know about those cards in hand. Then again, oh, they drew Thoughtseize, sure. They've drawn so much discard, their discard's kind of getting bad. I'm going to take Ancestral Recall. That's what I'm going to take. Take my Helm. So Crop Rotation is a good card, but they're not. I don't assume they have Stage Depths, but I think it's pretty likely that they have them both, but they're missing both, so they're not that close to killing me with it. They can Metamorph my V-click. They have so much discard. All they have is discard. That's okay. They've discarded every single card in my hand, and I put a good card on top. Sideboarding is going to be interesting because they have discard. They have Thoughtseize, Inquisition, Mind Twist, him, Grief, Collective Brutality. We've seen six so far. Okay, there goes the. They just straight up tutored for depths. Okay. That's weird because if you wait, you just tutor for the one you don't draw. Oh, they're just going to manually depths. I don't think that's going to work. All right, let's see. Let's see what we got. Oh wow, this is actually pretty awkward. I think I'm gonna actually have to turn about them. Oh man, if they draw a black source, it's so annoying. Well, I just gotta do what you gotta do. If they draw swamp, they still get to Collective Brutality me here. Because right now. Oh, they even missed taking a counter off. Not that that matters. Don't draw swamp. Don't draw swamp, please. Otherwise, they're taking my time spiral, which I don't really want them to do. All right, time to get all the discard back in the deck. Oh, here we go. What do we want to do here? I mean, at the very least, we can time twist her. So let's go. Let's just go frantic search to start with. You've already played my land. Let's put. Ooh, interesting. Interesting. I don't think we're gonna dig through time here. So let's just discard that. Probe them. What's in their hand? Their hand is Mind Twist, Grief. Yeah, a bunch of stuff. I think we go Breach. So PO casts 4 and gives me 2 back. That's not a very good deal. Let's go Frantic Search. Don't mind not drawing these again, I don't think. Discard 2, okay. Helm is interesting as well. Glad I didn't cast the Mana Vault yet. I can discard Island and PO, I think. Well, let's see. Oh, I think what I can do here is I can Mystical Tutor for Brain Freeze. Frantic Search into Brain Freeze. Yeah, that should be enough. Frantic Search. I guess actually, hold on. I think I do it this way. Mana Vault. Yeah. Helm. Because then now Frantic Search nets me mana. Not that that matters too much. Exile these 3. Discard Mountain and Remand. Untap these. So I've ran into my graveyard still. So now I can Brain Freeze you, but I also Brain Freeze myself 5 times. And then, all right, here we go. So I'm Brain Freeze myself a bunch, but not lethally. Well, not that I would die right now anyway. And now I'm going to Brain Freeze them. Well, hold on. Let's play Lion's Eye Diamond because I think I did see that. Lion's Eye Diamond. Sack this for blue. So here I think I actually am able to win even if they have an Eldrazi. Thanks to Ancestral Recall. And I can get my last 3 cards, right? Yeah. Because what I would do is if they have an Eldrazi, then, which they don't, and then I Ancestral Recall them. Okay, and I win. Hey, thanks for the raid, John Menkier. All right, so playing against a million discard spells. And acidic slime. This is tough. I had a million ways to win that game. But basically, if they have an Eldrazi, trigger on the stack, remand, brain freeze, freeze their deck again, Ancestral Lamb. Or I could have Ancestral them 3 times or whatever. Chain of Vapor is horrendous. Lotus Bloom, I think, is actually good. Because if they don't dress it early, I can just suspend it and it just eventually gets there. I don't really want Fast Bond. The Oracle Moldiah gets a lot more interesting. I mean, I'll put in Fast Bond given this, but it's not like a reason to do it. I wonder if I want like this stuff, like Primal Command, Satyr Wayfinder, Oracle, Nissa. Memory Jar is also interesting, but my main issue with Memory Jar is that they have acidic slime, so just like casting Memory Jar and passing is a little bit bad. Mm-hmm. I don't like Paradoxical Outcome as well, because that relies on me having a bunch of stuff in play and they're probably dressing me. It's gonna be like a low resource game. Like Brain Geyser is great, because even on like 5 lands, I just cast it and draw 3. Mm-hmm. Helm of Awakening, I also could consider cutting. Luteral Core is okay, but still not even that good if they're discarding. I wonder if I just put in Lotus and Memory Jar and call it a day. Because I like Oracle, but I don't really like Fastbond. No, Oracle does seem good enough. So let's put in Oracle, let's put in Fastbond. I actually think I'd probably take the helm out, take out a mountain, put in breeding pool, take out two islands, put in two forests. Maybe I put in three forests, actually. And then I'm just deciding if I want to go green enough. Primal Command is a way to reshuffle, but it doesn't really even get anything all that good. Yeah, let's do that. Let's just take out another island. So 12 islands. Yeah, that should still be plenty. And I have a Lotus Bloom as well. Dream Halls is still good, I think. Dream Halls is a really powerful card. I don't think I want Spring Bloom. No, this looks like about where I'm at. All right. Hey, this deck's getting put through its paces. Getting playing against some good ones. Ugh. I mean, I say ugh when this hand's obviously good. I'm just now paranoid they're going to Inquisition my Ancestral. I would really rather be able to have Mystical Tutor for it in response to discard. But that's okay. I'm not complaining about drawing an obviously quite good hand. It's just tough when they lead with discard. Yuck, the nuts, as someone said. Yes, yes, yes. All right, well, they mulliganed. Maybe they won't have a turn one discard spell, in which case I'll be pretty happy. So the question will then be, do I probe first or not? I kind of don't feel like I do. Okay, they didn't discard turn one. Turn one Hex Drinker is actually not bad because that's pressure. I'm definitely not casting Mana Vault here. Okay, if this is the game plan, I'm feeling pretty good about this because all their best cards are black cards and they went forest. The reason I cut Chain of Vapor is even though it bounces Merit Lodge, the 2020, it's so bad against discard. Just you can't really afford to draw cards like that when your opponent's discard and making you discard every turn. Oh, yeah, I guess Suspending Bloom would have been good. All right, let's now I actually do think I could Taxian Probe because I want to see what's going on. Oh, no, that was a mistake for that exact reason. Dang. Grave Titan, Mind Twist, Thoughtseize. Because I was like, I wanted to see if it was safe to play Oracle, but I was going to play the top card anyway. Hold on. Play my land. This looks pretty good. They can Thoughtseize one of my two Time Spirals if they draw a Swamp. Oh, they didn't level up before attacking? What did they draw? Okay. I take one. I think the Lotus Bloom's never going to come in this game. Because I think I'm going to win before it does. Land. Time Walk. Just wait. No real reason to pass. I mean, I could cast Time Twister, but with a Time Walk floating, but casting Time Spiral is still like close to that much mana. And okay, let's go. Yeah, Breeding Pool, Pay the Life, Island. Oh, there's a Fast Bond. Yeah. The problem is the only way I can really see losing here is if I pass, they draw Swamp, Mind Twist me for two, and they hit exactly those two. I just don't really see a reason to make that. Take that risk. Also, I don't non-sack Lion's Eye Diamond here. I have so much mana. Oh, I think we're gonna pull it out here. I think we're gonna get there. Let's go Ancestral. Time Walk. Storm Count is four. Let's Iteration put a. Let's see. This is tough. let's just put a Breach in hand. Bring it to the bottom, exile island. I could have exiled Breach and sacked LED to pay for it, but I just don't need to do that because dismiss this. Because I have why is this lit up? That's weird. Because I have Remand and Miscalc in hand, I can just wait. Plus Lotus Bloom's coming in, and I have a Time Walk turn coming. I think we're going to make the finals here. Despite my bad luck of drawing Ancestral in my opening hand, as I said. Breach. Brain Freeze myself. Do I even want to play the lands? I guess I even don't. They're probably... I can play a land off my deck. It's still bad. All right, let's add blue with Lion's Eye Diamond. Play Lion's Eye Diamond. Boom, boom. How much mana? I have a lot of mana. I have a lot of mana now. All right, let's just... Brain Freeze them. Exiling those three. And see how this works. Same targets. No Eldrazi's yet. I kind of hope they actually have an Eldrazi, because it'd be kind of fun to play that out. And then this is a breach for lethal now. Nope, Mind Twist, Dark Depths. Worldly Tutor, Utopia Sprawl. Vraska, Gravetide is our last card in Eldrazi. It is not. In that case, I will Ancestral Recall them. Exiling three cards, and that ought to do it. Ooh, on to the finals. Got away with something the first two matches, I think. I mean, I do think that match, despite all the discard, I have so many draw sevens that, like, unless I draw them all early and get them discarded, they have to have pressure, because making me discard my hand every two turns is not really going to get the job done. Man, another Ancestral Opener? Wait, no, that's actually great. Siggy, you missed round one. My opponent leads with Turn One Raghavan, and the next three cards they play are like Fable the Mirror Breaker, Force of Negation, Minsk and Boo, Glenelandra Archmage. They had a Force of Will, a Snapcaster, a Mox Zephyr. Their deck was also very good, but... They had a bad hand in game three, and I took advantage of it. Also, I opened Ancestral Time Walk. Oh no, I got past Ancestral. That actually was a pass. Oh, they had Mana Drain too. Yeah, that's a good card. All right, playing against a blue deck. Ooh, interesting. All right, here actually don't mind getting a little information. What is their hand? Consider Chain Lightning. Oh, aggro. Okay, let's lead with Mana Vault though. We can Ancestral next turn. Oh, the deck I'm playing is also busted. This deck is so good. I actually like that we played against such good decks. You know, we got, a Braid. They found that. Okay, they found Mountain of Braid. Well played. Okay, I don't really want to discard, so I'm just going to upkeep Ancestral because I know what their cards are. Oh, Remand's going to be really good here. Unless they draw a Mox or something, Remand is going to be great at countering their next play. I'm wondering if I want to play Helm of Awakening. The risk is that they don't have a land. I think I'm just going to wait a turn. Because I'm going to Remand what they play next. I'll discard an island here, I guess. Oh, wow. That was the last card? Oh, okay. I guess that's fine. That's unfortunate. I was really hoping that they were going to stall out. They've done a good job recovering from I think they mulligan to start. Okay, I'm going to Remand this. Oh, they didn't play Hellrider. Okay, are they playing Urza? Are they playing nothing? No, they're playing Urza. All right, we'll Remand that. Breach Ancestral myself isn't a terrible option. I lose Ancestral for after Time Spiraling. I could also Breach Mana Vault. Breaching just one card. I could also go Land, Helm, Play, Pass. They play Urza, but probably nothing else. And then I can Time Spiral, because I know that these are their four cards, plus they have one unknown in hand. I could also... Yeah, I'm debating playing... I think I'm going to play the Helm. I'm debating whether I play the Breach now or next turn. Because I could play Breach now. And then cast an Ancestral off the Breach. Or I can just play Breach next turn and have a Breach going. That actually seems pretty good. Let's just pass. If they draw an untapped land, they can go Urza, Hellrider, thanks to the Helm. But then they're tapped out. That's not so bad. All right, they're not Hellridering. I mean, I have to watch my life total. They have Chain Lightning in their deck. Clearly, they're an aggressive deck of some kind. Oh, interesting. Maybe they didn't realize they could Hellrider. Or do they have something else to play? Yeah, they probably should just cast the Hellrider if they don't have anything better. These are three of their four cards. And the way they tapped, they don't have a double blue card in hand, which is nice. So we can actually rule out a lot of the counter spells. Oh, they're going to play Seasoned Pyro. Okay. That was their other card. Sure. Doing it in that order works out well for me. They could still have a single blue counter up. They discarded Chain Lightning and Hellrider, keeping Zealous Conscripts. All right. If they time walk off this, it was going to be crazy. All right, land... Okay, Breach. Mana Vault, exiling. I'm going to keep... They're not playing Eldrazi in their deck, so I think I just keep Ancestral in my deck. If they drew a Remand or something off this, it's going to be pretty gross. Though I guess I can still technically Time Twister. Okay. Ooh, all right. Now we are cooking with gas. All right, time walk. Frantic Search. Yeah, I mean, this is a dub barring something very strange. Brain freeze myself. Four, and then one on them. What up, Rivmiv? Welcome back. They get to see what I got. And I'm at 14, so it's going to be pretty hard for them to burn me out, I would suspect. Didn't hit a Lion's Eye Diamond, but that's okay. One, two, three. Brain freeze them. I'll target myself with... No, they're done. All right. All right. Blue-red counters and aggressive stuff. Again, a good deck against this deck. I mean, the combination of pressure and counters is pretty good. And then... So the question is, do I want to side in something like Oracle? Fastbone I actually like a little less when they're burning us, but... Yeah, I don't really need Thassa's Oracle. I kind of feel like Maybe we're just good. I don't really. Lotus Bloom isn't really what I want. Chain. I don't love Chain of Vapor, but I'm not seeing something I really want instead. All right. Let's see. What do we got? This looks like a mulligan to me. This hand doesn't do anything for a long time. What about this hand? Honestly, I think this is better than a five card hand. Put paradoxical outcome back. They mold a six as well. Hopefully, they don't lead on a creature. If I draw one land, well, that was a bad draw. But if I draw one land, I have Remand and Miscalc, which is a really solid start. And Breach Helm is nice. All right, there's a Riftwing. Land, land, land. Ooh, Dream Halls. All right. Land, land, land. All right. Not looking good. I need to draw a land at some point here. And I guess I'm going to discard Mind's Desire. No, I'm going to discard Dream Halls. I think that I'm less likely to use that. I have yet to cast Dream Halls, but that's partially because this deck's so busted, it didn't need it. All right. All right, I feel good now. Just going to pass. They're going to play Riftwing. I'm going to remand it. Yeah, they're probably going to counter me back, but that's okay if they do. If they don't, yeah, I mean, look, I knew I was getting they were going to counter, but it uses up a counter. It's not like Riftwing's really getting me that badly. I don't have lands to play. Okay, they didn't have anything else. Land. Just gonna pass again. I'm not under much pressure, and I think there's a good chance I can miscalc something on their turn. Oh yeah, we're no, I'm not casting Phoenix Arch. We're definitely miscalcing the Expressive Iteration. Right. Let's see what we can do here, shall we? Helm of Awakening, any takers? Time walk, is that okay? Any time walks? Ooh, that's okay. That makes me feel like the other things I'm gonna do this turn are probably okay too. Frantic Search. What am I discarding? Guess these two. Untap these three. Oh, actually, maybe I should have kept Chain of Vapor. I don't know. Mana Vault for free. Breach. Chain of Vapor. Or sorry, Frantic Search. Exiling land. Miscalc Dream Halls. Discard. Island. Actually, I'm just going to discard Island, I think. Untap these three lands. So now I can turn about my lands. I think that's pretty good. It's break even on mana. Land, untap, and then I could Frantic Search. Or I think what I'm just going to do is Time Walk. At this point, I'm not Chain of Vaporing. And then that way I have an extra Time Walk turn if things go south. And then just Mind's Desire for seven here. Okay. Oh, yeah, Ancestral Recall. All right. That's fair. Time Twister, Brain Freeze. Feeling pretty good about this. Land. I could PO. It's kind of free. Sure, I'll PO those two. And let's go Mana Vault. Oh, I actually kind of don't want to play Helm. Because I don't want to end up giving them access to an extra mana. And then I'll brain freeze them and same target. 1, 2, 3, 4 to me. Same target. All right. Let's see if they sided in an Eldrazi. Again, if they did, we have them very easily covered. All right, let's go. Lion's Eye Diamond, exiling 3, and then we're in the home stretch here. Boom, boom. Sack this for blue. Lion's Eye Diamond, exiling 3. I just want to make sure I have enough mana for all this. And then brain freeze them. Exiling 1, 2, 3. And then brain freeze them. All right. Let's see if they got me. If they have the technology. Oh, their deck was sick. They had an ancestral too. We played against 3 sick decks this time around. No Eldrazi, it doesn't look like. Sag. But we had it either way. And that is how you'd never even come close to casting Dream Halls, the card I was even talking about the whole time. Whew, we got there. That was a nice one. This deck was definitely something, and I really did enjoy playing it. All it took was a Time Walk and an Ancestral Recall. but here we are. Beat, I think, 3 very good decks, and played against a lot of Force of Wills and Force Negations, and we still got there. All right. Thanks for watching. This draft was a lot of fun. And, you know, check out more drafts like this at channelfireball.com. And, of course, this draft was brought to you by Ultima Guard, sponsor of Team CFB. Thanks for hanging out. I'll see you next time.